treating them like dogs.
Yeah.
Immediately, police materialized from various sectors of the temple, crackling into radios. The monks were set upon. Several of us saw the monks being beaten to the ground. The monks who were at the edge of this maroon stream of humanity, beaten in the ground. Some of them were kicked in the stomach.
And more than 100 marchers moved to Tibetan exile, have been reminded.
This is what's been happening all day here in Beijing. Every time the BBC starts mentioning something about Tibet, Chinese censors black out the channel. And this is what you can see on Chinese state TV, an ordinary discussion about politics, no mention whatsoever of Tibet.
From exile in northern India, Tibet's spiritual leader, the Dalai Lama, is watching. China accuses him and his supporters of premeditated sabotage. And he's called the protests a sign of the deep-rooted resentment of the Tibetan people.
Even now, after 4 days, we do not know how many were shot, how many are injured, how many are arrested. We don't have the real figure, and this is, I think, a big concern.
And in London, protesters have gathered outside the Chinese embassy. Gordon Brown said that he's very concerned about what's happening in Tibet. But at the moment, there's no talk of Britain boycotting China's Olympics this summer in Beijing. China had seen this year as the perfect chance to show off some fresh images of a new, more confident China. But instead, the world has a darker set of pictures to study. It's not the kind of photo album that China had in mind for 2008. James Reynolds, BBC News, Beijing.